Welcome to Mama Man's Kitchen. Why is it Mama Man's Kitchen? Because everybody called me Mama Man. That's how that happened. Today we're making an easy meal for you moms, for you dads coming in from work. This is going to take you probably about 20 minutes maybe to prepare, but it's going to take you about 30 minutes to bake, 30 to 45 minutes. I'm making homemade pot pie. My mother-in-law introduced it to me, and I'm introducing it to y'all. Here we go. Today we're going to make it easy. You're going to get some pre-cooked chicken fajita meat from the store. Y'all see this brand, whatever brand you want to use. We're using some frozen vegetables, whatever brand you want to use. And we also using some Pillsbury crust, baby, already rolled up, prepared for you to do today. All right, so we got that going on. We're going to move this out of the way. And we're going to use some canned cream of chicken soup. We already got that together. We got it in a bowl, looking all pretty. So that's all. I'm gonna pop this out of the way so I make some space for myself. We got a one potato. We're gonna dice him up real good. We got our cream of chicken soup here. We have our chicken fajita meat. We have our frozen vegetables. So I'm gonna start off with peeling this potato. And we're gonna peel them really nice. Hey, I'm good with a knife. We're gonna peel them real nicely, get you some nice diced potatoes, because we're gonna start him off boiling first with our vegetables. We're gonna put that on. Put that in some nice water right quick to get that going. And it's okay. You know what? Sometimes people get real nervous if you have some little sprouts on your potatoes. Knock them off, baby. Cut them off. You can still use that potato. It's not a bad potato. Just because for you young people who scared that it ain't no good. It is good. You know, you still just peel them off. Hey, I was raised in a family. Sometimes you have to use these to make homemade french fries. Have you ever made homemade french fries? I'll show you that another day. But this is something good. We got some seasonings here that we're going to put on our chicken. I'm getting him all diced up for you. I have to put your potato on some water so it won't turn brown on you, okay? So that's what I'm doing right here. This is a... So we're going to slice them up. We're going to slice them up real nicely for you. Right here, we're gonna break it down like you're making homemade french fries, because you don't want it to be too thick so it can cook fast. Just for, show y'all my knife work. Look at that. Make them all nice and pretty. For some people, you may have to do one at a time. So when you slice them, you wanna get them a nice little thickness. You can lay that down, but this is just what it looks like. I'm just cutting. So this nice potato, you don't dice them up nice little size so it won't be too thick when you get ready to put it inside of your pot pie. So when it bake and when it boil, you can get him, it won't take that long to cook otherwise. That's how that goes on this part. So we dicing him up. And you want to keep it always in water. This is another way you can do it. Okay, I'm gonna take him, slice him up right. So we're gonna come in there, we're gonna slice this up real neatly. Not too thick, just so it can boil real fast. So we're gonna dice this up. You got me? Gonna dice that up nicely right there. You always got a little piece right here. I had sliced up right there. Then we're gonna put him in the water. Uh-oh, dropped a few of them. Man, I needed all them potatoes, but okay, we got it. We got it. Okay, so we got all that out the way. Right there, they got a potato going. I'm gonna go over here and I'm gonna pull this water off. Pull this water off of him, because you wanna make sure you wash them off where it's clean. We're gonna put a little bit of water on this so when we put it in the pot, we're gonna add our mixed vegetables to it. I'm gonna turn some fire on. Okay, put him in there. Then we're gonna add your mixed vegetables. Your mixed vegetables. Now, if you don't like all these, you can buy them individually. Like you can get corn, carrots, you can get green beans individually and just mix it up like that. So we're gonna, but I buy mixed vegetables with all of them in it. And I also add potatoes. Sometimes when you get some in the store, they don't come with all those vegetables in it, but I like all those vegetables myself. So what we're gonna do is just add just a little garlic to that, just so you can have a little seasoning in that water. We're gonna boil him down. While he's boiling down, we're gonna chop up, take the potatoes, put that away. We're gonna chop up our fajita chicken that we have here. But while we're chopping that up, we're gonna turn on some fire to get your, if this heat up, we're gonna use just a little oil in here. This is olive oil. It's blessed. Nah, we didn't bless, I'm just playing. we're gonna chop this up while that's heating. Got your nice knife for that. Nice knife for that, for chopping. So we're gonna chop the chicken up. Just so it won't be too big. You don't want it to be too big and then it can spread. And we're gonna use this probably about 9. It don't say what this is, but it's about a 9 by something. I don't know. But just a small pan. But you can go as big as you want. If your family's bigger, you can go with a bigger pan. And of course, you're gonna add a little bit more chicken. This was probably about a half a cup of grilled chicken. About a half a cup of grilled chicken that I used on that. So, y'all know this is a little TV, so I'm just chopping this up. That's how you do. You put a little weight on it. Put a little strength on that. Dice him up. Got your skillet heated up right there. People, y'all always want me to cook now, so I'm in here cooking. Mr. Man been trying to get me in here to do this, and I'm like, I don't want to do all that talking. But I guess I'm talking, huh? All right, we're going to put a little... It ain't hot yet. So when you hear that sizzling, then you know your skillet is hot. So we're gonna wait on that to heat up a little bit more. It's coming. Heat your pan up so it won't take so long. It's sizzling. Got a little sizzle coming. Y'all hear that sizzle? Nah, you can't hear it. Okay. Got a little bit. Let's see. You hear? He coming. There he is. Oh! We're just gonna put about a teaspoon and a half of onion, diced onion. You can also buy that already chopped up to save yourself if you don't like chopping up onion. Adding that chicken in there. You hear that sizzle? Don't that sound good? All right, we got him going. We're gonna use all our meat, all our little crumbs and everything, especially if you got a big family. And you can take this for lunch. It's easy to warm up. It tastes good warmed up. You hear that sizzle? All right, we got a little seasoned salt right here. This is like a teaspoon and a half, but I'm not gonna use all that. We're trying to keep down on the salt, okay? So really probably use about a teaspoon. See, I still got about a half left. But I'm gonna use all this garlic though. This is granulated garlic. To me, granulated garlic is better than garlic salt because it's not an extra salt that you're adding to the actual to the meat, so it's not too salty. Because you have to remember that your soups have a lot of sodium in them. So sodium is your salt. It already has a lot intake in there. So I'm gonna put that on. I'm boiling my potatoes. Lost a little bit of meat right there. You know, I be trying to catch everything. I'm cooking for a bunch of people. So I'm seasoning it, warming this up. Basically the chicken, the fajita chicken is already done pretty much, so you're just heating it up and you're grilling your onions with it to just give it a little bit more flavor. So we got that going. While that's going, we're gonna move along. We're gonna open this up. We're gonna get our pan ready for our crust. So I'm opening up. Again, this is pre-crust that comes in the... It's normally by your eggs and butter that you pick this up in the grocery store. It's already done. Look, it's already made. You ain't got to do all that. So you're gonna just take this, unroll it, And it's good to actually take it out of the freezer and take it out of the refrigerator and let it thaw out. Uh-oh, had a little boo-boo right there, tore, trying to go too fast. But you lay this off inside of your pan. It could be, actually, you could actually buy pie crust. If you don't want to do this one, and you just dump it in, use the same pan if you don't want to have all these dishes to wash. But you're going, this is going to actually make up quite a bit. That's like a cup and a half of mixed vegetables. And then you have also another cup and a half of chicken. So we putting this in there. I got me a little small spatula to just help pin them and push them to the sides. You want to try to get your crust as high to the sides as you can. Because that's the thing that we like. We like crust. You know, you want that bread on there. You want a little something on there, right? All right, so I'm spreading it out with this to keep from tearing it, because your crust will tear pretty easy if you're not careful. So we're going to push them out. Got my meat going over here, so we're checking on that. I'm going to turn the fire down on that, because remember, it's already done. It's already ready. So what we're going to do is, since that's ready, we're going to cut the fire off on that. We're going to add our cream of chicken to it. Skillet is already hot. Mix all this together. You hear him sizzling together? He's marinating. You're marinating them all together. You're shaking them up. So this is all good right there. All right. But this is one of the favorite meals of my family. And it's a quick meal. And you get the kids to eat all the vegetables and the meat at the same time. That's the important part. For them to get everything, all the vegetables, your meat. Because you need a well-rounded meal, not just a whole bunch of starch, but you need a well-rounded meal. And this is something I had to learn, and I'm trying to do, you know, stick to my health and wellness and getting better with that. So we have to be mindful of it. I'm trying to keep this, I want these vegetables to go on boil. See, because the potatoes with them diced up, don't take them that long to cook. By 5-7 minutes, pretty much this is done, because it's going to cook more when you put it in the oven. So this right here is all mixed up, and then we're gonna mix all that with the vegetables in just a second. I'm gonna go back to my crust over here, smooth this out. Y'all, I've become a better talker. Hoo-hoo, used to be scared to death to be talking in front of people. Y'all was like, for real? Tam was scared, she was real scared. So I'm smoothing this out, and we're gonna put this, get him ready, so when we get ready to put all our, putting all my stuff together, so I'm gonna open this one up so I can get ready to put it on top. So check on these other vegetables. See, they get soft. All you want to do is get real soft. The potatoes is almost there, just a couple more minutes, but actually it'll finish cooking when you put it in the oven, because it's gonna take it probably about 30, depending on your oven, 30-45 minutes. Because you want your crust to get brown on the bottom. Don't try to cook it too fast. Just take your time. To be a good cook, you can't cook fast. You gotta take your time and love it. I'm not saying you gotta be in love with cooking, but you know, preparation and presentation mean everything to me for my family, even for my kids. When I'm cooking for my husband, my kids, I want it to look good, smell good, taste good, all the goods. There you go, right? Just, you know, something like that. But we put a little seasoning in that. I'm gonna put a little bit more of that seasoned salt in there just to doctor these vegetables up, since they was frozen. You want to be right. Okay, that's looking good right there. Just two more seconds on that, and we're gonna drain all but a little water off of this. And I'm gonna put this in a, gotta step down here. Show y'all all of my equipment. I'm being noisy. That's how you is in the kitchen. You know, they show you working in the kitchen. That means you working in the kitchen. Okay, so I rinsed that off. Make sure you want to rinse all your stuff off. So I'm going to take these vegetables, because they're done. Y'all want to see that? Look at that. Come on in there and get that. Hey, my cameraman. Come on in there and get it. You see it? You see him up there? See it down there? Well, who all looking at it? That's it. That's what we looking like. So we're gonna pour out most of this water off of these vegetables. I'm gonna want you to come back in. I'm gonna show y'all how. See how these potatoes? See, they're pretty much just done. That piece didn't come loose, but it's done. See, but these hands is used to cooking. That's why they can hold that heat. Don't be like me now. Don't try to be like me. Get you a fart. Because you might burn yourself. All right, so we're going to take all of this. And we're going to put him in here. We're going to mix all this together. I say him. This cream. This is your cream of chicken. This is also your onions and your fajita meat. I'm all about keeping it clean when I'm cooking. So y'all see me moving, but I wash dishes as I cook, so I won't have all that once you finish. But we mix all this together. See that? Mixing all that together right there. Right there, we got your little medium-sized pot. Mm-hmm. Tastes real good right there. Yeah. And it's okay, you can also use this, you can use this filling actually as a soup. If you want to make a soup, you can use this as a soup. You can add more soup to it, heavy cream to loosen them up a little bit and have you a cream soup. It's about to be fall, it's about to be cold. You can use that for that. So we're gonna take him, pull this over in here. We ain't gonna put all of it in there because it may be too full. Get them ready for you. So we got half of that in there. Got our crust up over here. All right, you got that in there. So that's what that's gonna look like inside of that. Y'all see it? So what we're gonna do, we took this out, we're gonna add our top to the crust. So what you do is you take him and you fold it back a little bit. So you take the crust and you fold him back. Fold that back, because it's coming over a little bit. So you take it and you fold him under. And what you're gonna do is press this against the sides so your crust will stay up. Because remember, it's all about the crust. It's all about the crust. So we got that. You can take a fork. Now I got right here is a knife. So I'm gonna take him and I'm gonna press this. This gonna make you pretty. Don't that pretty? So you're gonna take this part, you're gonna press this down all the way around. And after we do that, we're gonna slice a few little holes in it just to let the air out so it'll bake. All right, and we're moving. So we're taking the pie, or the chicken pot pie, to the oven. So we gonna bake him at 350. Let me open this up. So what you gonna do is you gonna split the time. We're gonna bake him for about 45 minutes. But you wanna do half of the time on the bottom so the crust can get brown on the bottom. And then you take him and put him on top. So that's 45 minutes. Then whatever that is, but just kinda gauge it on your oven. If your oven cook fast, watch it. So in case you need to take it to the top, just so it can brown on top. There we go. We're gonna bake him 45 minutes and we'll be back. Okay, so we done let him cook half on the bottom. We're gonna take him to the top for you. He's starting to get brown on the side a little bit. The pie is starting to get brown some on the side. We're gonna let that bake for the rest of the time. And then you're gonna have your homemade pot pie. Chicken pot pie. You can do it with beef. You can put shrimp in it if you want. Whatever you need, you can get it. You can get whatever you need. Chicken, shrimp, beef. You know, you can make whatever kind you want. Or no meat at all. I have made one for Mr. Man with no meat, so you can do that. All right, there we go. Guess what? We got a baked pot pie. Come on to the oven with me. Come on over here. Look at him. Look at it. Oh, look at that. Ain't that nice? Look at that. Nice and crispy looking. We're going to sit him right there, right? I'm ready. I ain't going to be able to wait for the family. My mouth is watering. Look at that. Now you can cut him or you can dip him, whatever you want to do. But I think I'm just going to kind of cut it so it'll look a little. I ain't going to get that much up. I'm just going to get a little bit. Look at that. It's nice and brown. We got a little bowl right here. And we're gonna taste it. Look at that. Ooh, look how that nice thing it came out of there. Look at that. Look at that. Just like a pie. Ain't that nice? Don't that pretty? And guess what? Baby, I got pie pie. A hot chicken pie pie. Boy, this is so good. You can slap your mama. Now, don't you do that. Hey, I love y'all. This is 30 Minute Meal Cooking with Mama Man. But remember, y'all, instead of judging, judge less and love more. That's how we're going to do it nowadays. We're going to judge less, we're going to love more. But I'm going to enjoy this. Bless it, Lord. Purify it. In Jesus' name. Baby, I got chicken pie pie.